Hey, what's up, you guys? This is Junior Trader, and in this video, we are taking a look at Tesla, Microsoft, Apple, Meta, Netflix, Google, Amazon, Palantir, and also Spy and QQQ. Well, so today, as you would have seen on the thumbnail of this video, a cautionary day, or is it a start of all of us to be a bit cautious in the market, right? Now, why so? Well, because across the market, across multiple stocks, and I'll be going through many updates in this video, especially starting off with Tesla, because it's a robo-taxi event week. But you see across the market today, Microsoft just giving me the move that I was expecting, breaking further below. And overall, we have a lot red in the market today. Oh, well, I forgot. We'll talk about NIO as well, okay? Now, so yes, we are going through some slippage in the market. And is this a beginning of a bigger sell-off, or is there a chance that we are seeing some stabilization? So in this video, let's talk about all of that. And I'll be doing another video on my Junior Trader Dividend Investing channel later today. I did sell some more stocks today because I'm sizing out as I'm seeing some weakness in the market on some of those holdings that I have. And I'll cover all the details in this video, or sorry, on this channel of mine, Dividend Investing. Link to this channel is in the description below. Subscribe here as well if you want to be notified when that video comes out. Now, so starting off with Tesla, let's turn on my Easy Day and Swing trading tool first. And on the overall daily structure, from last 3 days, we are in a little bit of a negative structure, as a red structure. So at least for now, yes, it's a sign that this daily interval of upside move that was happening, this is the time where you should be cautious, right? You should be either trading only intraday and, you know, not taking any swing long position right now because we are going through cool off. This was the time, like, take all the profits in the swing long position. And now it's that, the reason I'm not saying it's a swing short also because we are still technically in a trajectory of upside. But yes, it's not a swing long right now. It's not a swing short as well. Intraday, it is few days up, right? And down as well. So it's right now just intraday plays, at least Tesla right now. And as I'll take you to the hourly interval, and I have my tool turned on right now. Let me just turn it off so that you can see it in perspective. So this is what we have as what we see the candlesticks, right? But if I turn on my tool, you can see today was a negative day. We overall on the hourly interval, we had a good green day upside on the structure as well when structure turned bullish. That constituted just as a rebound back again to the cloud. And you can see we just rejected that cloud and today it remained in the red negative structure. So Tesla is cooling off at least at those peaks. And that's why I have been selling off of my original positions. Some I'm partially taking profits, right? And that's what I'll be talking about in my Junior Trader Dividend Investing channel. What I sold on Tesla, how much I still hold. And I have sold some other positions as well in other stocks. But I'll talk about that on that channel. So that remains the case that Tesla is a little bit weaker. And today, well, yeah, as I showed you, we rejected below the cloud. We also rejected underneath of 200 hours moving average. And unfortunately, yeah, that was the day, guys. As I just showed you the structure, it was a red day. And then we did try to stabilize at the next significant level, 244. But since the trend was already to the downtrend today, that just resulted into a little bit of a rebound. And then we just continued lower. Now, what to watch for tomorrow, right? I would still say just trade it intraday, either direction. But this is the level. If we stay below 244.24 on Tesla tomorrow, look for the downside plays. If we get above it, then only look for the upside plays. There's another, if any rebound needs to be played to the upside, then you are watching for that level 237. But that's only a rebound zone for tomorrow if the rebound price action starts to build itself up here at 208.37. Now, also with Tesla, the important thing is that it all comes down to the robotaxi day, and that is 10th of October. So that will all define the sentiment on Tesla from thereafter. Otherwise, this cool off is fine, right, on the overall structure as long as we still are above this trend line. But yeah, that's a cool off at least that is happening on Tesla, right? So that's that for Tesla. Let's talk about Neo real quick because it's going to be very quick and then we'll jump into the tech stock. So Neo, guys, it's going sideways into that supply zone, but the thing is with that is right now, as long as it can hold above 20 days moving average, it's fine. If we start to lose it, that's where we have a problem. And also if we start to lose $6.34, that's where we have a problem. For stronger, much more upside, we need to stay above $7. That's an important zone, okay? But that's pretty much what Neo is for me right now that I want to talk about. Let's talk Microsoft. So Microsoft, if you have seen my video over the weekend as well, I talked about that this is looking like it's gonna continue lower. And on Microsoft, if I turn on my Easy Day and Swing Trading tool, the structure has been negative, guys, from many days, like 2 weeks already, okay? And we are still in the negative structure. We are still downtrending. The thing is that at this point, this is what I was waiting because I will be buying Microsoft eventually in my dividend investing portfolio. And I was waiting for these pullbacks or sell-offs so that it becomes cheaper for me. And it's just giving me that. But it's for active trading, it's still a negative trade. There is no upside right now in the structure. So let's go to the hourly interval. And yep, it's full on in the downtrend. There is, as long as we stay below the level now, 413, it's just in the downtrend, Microsoft, okay? Right now, there is no upside in the structure on Microsoft. Apple also selling off deep red. Now, since it has lost 20 and 50 days moving average and also has lost this support area that it was trying to hold at 224, I won't be surprised if it comes down to this trend line. But anyways, if you are planning to trade this cool off, stop loss has to be above 224 area somewhere here on the short side, right? So that's that. But yes, Apple is looking weaker in the structure. It can cool off to this trend line. And we'll see if it cool off further after that. But that's the first possibility. Meta, just like the rest of the market, it's cooling off as well today. But overall structure on this is still technically bullish, okay? But take partial profits regardless. But Meta is still in the overall bullish structure. I would not short swing it. All right. If it's in, technically the play on this is we are in the bullish structure. When you see a red day, it's time to take partial profits. Right. It's still technically in the bullish play. Right. So don't swing short it. Intraday. Yeah. Intraday, you can short it. That's different than swing. But overall structure, you can't short it for multiple days because structure is not weaker. It's not in that direction. It's just that Meta is doing its cool off. Intraday, it was a weaker play. You can see it went all-time highs and then a little bit sold off. That was a liquidity grab on this part, right? And yeah, but this is pretty much the zone of support, 483. If it can hold above it, it is still fine, right? And look, even if it pulls back all the way to 20 days moving average, it's still fine. It's been just very extended. It's just doing its pullbacks and cool offs right now. Netflix, on the other hand, is at a precarious place. It's like just at a place level. If we lose close below it or even be below this tomorrow, like 701, it will start to look a lot more weaker. This is the level and looks like it is looking weaker now. The way it lost today level of 711 and testing 701. Below this, we are losing the structure and this may continue lower to then 50 days moving average as the first level. Google, I have an update on Google in my Junior Trader Dividend Investing channel today. Video will be coming out later today, so don't forget to check it out. But yeah, Google right now seems like it is a little bit looking weaker again, okay? And now we are seeing if this level, if Google can hold itself above somehow 160, there is still a chance for it to try to form a pivot. But just because we have lost this level 163.92, and I think structure has closed negative as well on this today. Yeah, we have a in the structure negative candle as well. I do think now Google will slow down. Looks like with Microsoft, Google, Apple, everything is slowing down and you will see the effect in SPY and QQQ. This is the time to not just be cautious, but also be more careful because a little bit tide looks like it's turning, okay? That's why we do these analysis daily because we have to see what the price action is telling us on a day-to-day basis. That's what defines the moves as they would happen. Amazon. So Amazon on the a daily interval is still in the remained in the negative structure even after that rebound to the upside. And Yeah, this actually I wasn't expecting, but this was the level 183 and 48. Since I mentioned that, as long as it can stay above it now, it's fine. Unfortunately, it opened below that. So it was a really brutal start for Amazon in the pre-market itself, right? It just lost in the pre-market 183 and 38 cents area, and it was over. That was the last possibility for it to try to hold. But yeah, right now it remains in the negative structure, guys. It's just in the negative downtrending structure. Amazon, these are the zones. If it can hold here, we'll have to see a pivot to the upside. That is 250 days moving average. If it can't, yeah, right now it's still in the downtrend. I'm not seeing any upside. Palantir doing a cool off with the whole market today, but overall structure on this is still bullish. What do I mean by that, right? So there's a blue box that I provided you as a breakout zone, right? We got those beautiful breakouts. Now it's doing a cool off, but as long as it's above 38 and 21 cents, this is just a pullback. Technically, structure, as I just showed you using my tool as well, it's still in the bullish structure. And if you need access to my tools, links are in the description below. My tools can be used across multiple intervals. You can use them for day trading, swing trading, whatever, however you want. All right, let's take a look at now SPY and QQQ before wrapping up. So here's an interesting part. SPY and QQQ, they're derivatives of all other tech stocks. So I just showed you in all other stocks, we are seeing negativity, bearishness signals developing, especially like big percent holders like Microsoft and Apple. Even though we are not in the bearish structure on SPY, but just looking at the other stocks, we are not far away from getting weaker. But technically, this is the level 565 and 13 cents. If we lose this on S&P 500, we would start to have a problem. And let's move this blue box down there so you can. This is the zone. If we lose this on SPY, yeah, there you can expect more weakness. And let's take a look at QQQ. And with QQQ, pretty much, I'm willing to give it actually some benefit of, the moves of the other stocks today, but this is the zone, 20 days moving average. If we lose it, then weakness is possible. So, but yeah, it's looking again, as I just showed you, the tech stocks are showing some sign of weakness, and so is, with that, QQQ will reflect that because it's a derivative, right? So, yeah, but you are watching 20 days moving average for that, and I would say $477 level as well. That's where the next pivot is. If we lose it, you can expect weakness starts to happen. So, yep, so just keep in mind this week, and also, guys, there is, election is coming close in US, so market may be a little bit, reacting to that as well now. So there's a possibility market, may react until that day, and then we'll see a flip, whatever direction it does, right? So, but yeah, expect some lot more reactionary stuff happening nowadays. Okay. All right. Well, that's it for this video. And if you found it helpful, valuable, please hit the like, subscribe. And with that, I'll see you in my next video. So if you need access to my tools, links are in the description below. All right. Bye.